Ladies and gentlemen, would you please rise? Dissemble nor cloak them before the face of Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, but confess them with a humble, lowly, penitent, and obedient heart, to the end that we may obtain forgiveness of the same by His infinite goodness and mercy. And although we at all times ought humbly to acknowledge our sins before God, yet ought we most chiefly so to do, when we assemble and meet together, to render thanks for the great benefits that we have received at His hands, to set forth His most worthy praise, to hear His most holy word, and to ask those things which are requisite and necessary, as well for the body as the soul. Wherefore I pray and beseech you, as many as are here present, to accompany me with a pure heart and humble voice unto the throne of the heavenly grace, saying after me, Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from thy ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against thy holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And there is no health in us. But thou, O Lord, have mercy upon us, miserable offenders. Spare thou them, O God, which confess their faults. Restore thou them that are penitent, according to thy promises declared unto mankind, in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for His sake, that we may hereafter live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of thy holy name. Amen. Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who desireth not the death of a sinner, but rather that he may turn from his wickedness and live, and hath given power and commandment to his ministers, to declare and pronounce to his people, being penitent, the absolution and remission of their sins, he pardoneth and absolveth all them that truly repent and unfeignedly believe his holy gospel. Wherefore, let us beseech him to grant us true repentance and his Holy Spirit, that those things may please him which we do at this present, and that the rest of our life hereafter may be pure and holy, so that at the last we may come to his eternal joy, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
Then Moses turned and went down from the mountain, carrying the two tablets of the covenant in his hands, tablets that were written on both sides, written on the front and on the back. The tablets were the work of God, and the writing was the writing of God, engraved upon the tablets. When Joshua heard the noise of the people as they shouted, he said to Moses, "There is a noise of war in the camp." But he said, "It is not the sound made by victors or the sound made by losers. It is the sound of revelers that I hear." As soon as he came near the camp and saw the cart and the dancing, Moses' anger burned hot, and he threw the tablets from his hands and broke them at the foot of the mountain. He took the calf that they had made, burned it with fire, ground it to powder, scattered it on the water, and made the Israelites drink it. Now Moses used to take the tent and pitch it outside the camp, far off from the camp. He called it the tent of meeting, and everyone who sought the Lord would go out to the tent of meeting, which was outside the camp. Whenever Moses went out to the tent, all the people would rise and stand, each of them at the entrance of their tents, and watch Moses until he had gone into the tent. When Moses entered the tent, a pillar of cloud would descend and stand at the entrance of the tent, and the Lord would speak with Moses. When all the people saw the pillar of cloud standing at the entrance of the tent, all the people would rise and bow down, all of them, at the entrance of their tent. Thus the Lord used to speak to Moses face to face, as one speaks to a friend. Here ends the first lesson.
Instead,
brothers and sisters, to keep an eye on those who cause dissensions and offences, in opposition to the teaching that you have learned. Avoid them. For such people do not serve our Lord Jesus Christ, but their own appetites, and by smooth talk and flattery, they deceive the hearts of the simple-minded. For while your obedience is known to all, so that I rejoice over you, I want you to be wise in what is good and guileless in what is evil. The God of peace will shortly crush Satan under your feet. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Timothy, my co-worker, greets you. So do Lucius and Jason and Sosipater, my relatives. I, Tertius, the writer of this letter, greets you in the Lord. Gaius, who is host to me and the whole church, greets you. Erastus, the city treasurer, and our brother Quartus greets you. Now to God, who is able to strengthen you according to my gospel and the proclamation of Jesus Christ, according to the revelation of the mystery that was kept secret for long ages, but is now disclosed, and through the prophetic writings is made known to all the Gentiles, according to the command of the eternal God, to bring about the obedience of faith to the only wise God, through Jesus Christ, to whom be the glory forever. Amen. Here ends the second lesson.
Of saints. Almighty and everlasting God, give to us the increase of faith, hope, and charity, and that we may obtain that which thou dost promise. Make us to love that which thou dost command, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
O God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works do proceed, give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that both our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee, we being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness, through the merits of Jesus Christ our Saviour.
Amen.
Lighten our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy, defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of thy only Son,
just take this opportunity to say thank you to Jim Abrams and the King Singers. Oh, if I beg your pardon. That's a rival group, isn't it? The Cathedral Singers who have joined us here today. It's wonderful to have you back, particularly after such a long gap where you weren't able to be, well, none of us were able to go anywhere much, but it's wonderful to have you with us and sharing in worship this afternoon. I was notified before the service that the VPO, the virtual pipe organ that Jim has been playing for us, celebrates its, which anniversary was it?
10th.
The 10th anniversary, which is roughly about the time the church was consecrated, isn't it?
A bit after that,
yes. Yes, so wish the organ happy birthday. It's great to hear this afternoon. The Australian Lecture and New Testament readings at evening prayer have been from St. Paul's letter to the Romans since the 18th of June. So that's a rather long period. And I could almost guarantee that very few, if any of you, have kept up with the lectionary readings every Sunday evening, except for members of the Cathedral Singers, of course. Don't worry, I won't ask for a show of hands. My point is that the readings are organised in such a way that there's a sequence to them. One follows the other. The readings for Sundays and weekdays follow on from the previous day or the previous week. So the readings from the letter to the Romans don't make much sense unless you know what the readings for the day before or the day after were. The readings only make sense if one either attends every service in the prayer book or the lectionary, or uses the lectionary and prayer book regularly, which clergy do or are supposed to do, and many other people, lay people that I'm familiar with, also use that. At morning tea after the 10:30 Eucharist on Fridays, we were talking about how when we were younger, the practice was to attend church regularly, first of all, and often twice on a Sunday. There would be morning prayer, or matins, as it was called, either said or sung, and then evening prayer, or evensong, either said or sung. It wasn't unusual for people to go to both, in the morning, one in the evening. In addition to that, there was usually an early morning service of Holy Communion. All that to say that when I looked up the New Testament reading for evening prayer today, I discovered it was the very last chapter of the letter to the Romans, filled with names that very few of us have ever heard of or know about, together with some random final instructions and greetings and exhortations. And I thought to myself, what the dickens am I going to say about all this? By the way, that expression, what the dickens, has nothing to do with Charles Dickens. It apparently was a euphemism for the devil. So you could say another word instead of dickens. But you can read the book of Romans when you go home. You can catch up and place the final chapter in sequence. Our reading was from the second part of the final chapter of Romans. In his letters, Paul invariably concludes with a series of greetings and expressions of gratitude for those who have helped him in his ministry. The reading begins in verse 17, and I'd just like to very briefly focus on that, because it's very pertinent to what's happening in our world today, including Australia right now. I urge you, brothers and sisters, to keep an eye on those who cause dissensions and offences in opposition to the teaching that you have learned. Avoid them, for such people do not serve our Lord Christ, but their own appetites. And by smooth talk and flattery, they deceive the hearts of the simple-minded. While our involvement may be limited in the political arena, we can show the love of Christ in our daily lives, in our families, our work, our relationships, We must, as Paul says elsewhere, maintain the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. We must do all we can to heal the divisions of Christ's church. In Jesus' high priestly prayer, in John chapter 17, he prays for unity for his disciples, that they may all be one, as you, Father, are in me, and I am in you. May they also be in us, so that the world may believe that you have sent me. Paul also says, I want you to be wise in what is good and guileless in what is evil. Be discerning, be wise, and above all, be loving. Stand for the offering.
Thank you. Let us pray. Let us pray for the peace in our world, the leaders of nations, and all in authority. God of light and salvation, our refuge and our strength, we pray especially for the people of Israel and Palestine amid the escalating violence. We pray for those killed and injured by rockets from Gaza in the southern Israel. May your rod and staff comfort them. We pray for those who are grieving. May they know your ever-present help. We pray for the protection of those who have been taken hostage. As they walk through the valley of, may they fear no evil. We pray for the citizens of Gaza, may know that their help comes from the Maker of heaven and earth. And we pray for those in leadership in Gaza and Israel. May you guide them along the right path. We ask this in union with Christ and trusting in the power of your Holy Spirit. God of grace, hear our prayer. We pray for the bereaved and the lonely, for the sick and the suffering, remembering especially those that are on our hearts and minds. We pray for those countries affected by natural disaster, especially for Afghanistan, as they once again experience another violent earthquake. Be with them in their suffering and grief. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
Following the result of the referendum, we pray for the sorrow felt by many. Help us to bring about spiritual and social change to improve the quality of life for all groups in our communities, especially the disadvantaged. Help young people to find true dignity and self-esteem by your Spirit. May your power and love be the foundations on which we build our families, our community, and our nation, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
We pray for ourselves and for each other. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
We praise you, Lord God, for the communion of saints and the glorious hope of the resurrection to eternal life. Almighty God, who has given us grace at this time, with one accord, to make our common supplications unto thee, and hast promised that when two or three are gathered together in thy name, thou wilt grant their request. Fulfill now, O Lord, the desires and petitions of our servants, as may be most expedient for them. Grant us in this world knowledge of thy truth, and in the world to come, life everlasting.
Amen. Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit,
be with us all evermore. Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
invited to share afternoon tea with us this afternoon, and we are very grateful to the Women's Fellowship for preparing that for us today. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, be amongst you and remain with you always.